This is for Trump 2020!
And so it is in the race for the White House, the home stretch, finally. Celebrated this weekend with Trump-flagged boats racing along rivers in multiple states. And though things didn't go well for all of them, a handful somehow sank in waters off Texas, it's clear the Donald Trump and Joe Biden campaign machines are geared to go for what promises to be an ugly, divisive, potentially violent contest. This week comes the latest tell-all book on the president from Trump's one-time personal lawyer, Michael Cohen, now a felon, convicted of campaign finance crimes and of lying to Congress. Now warning Trump will do anything to win.
I believe that he would even go so far as to start a war in order to prevent himself from being removed from office.
But the talk this weekend is all about American wars past, with multiple reports that while on a visit to Europe in 2018, Trump privately called U.S. soldiers losers and suckers for being killed in action, putting Trump loyalists today on defense.
This president supports the military in an unbelievable way. He's created more funding to rebuild the military. That was one of the things he campaigned on and he delivered.
Then there's the suggestion lately by Trump of a fast-tracked COVID vaccine by November, a potential boost for Trump's bid at re-election, said the Biden campaign today on its likely safety.
I would not trust Donald Trump. I will not take his word for it. He wants us to inject bleach. I will not take his word.
As the race now begins in earnest, Donald Trump is lagging behind in most polls. Then again, that's roughly where he was this time 4 years ago. Paul Hunter, CBC News, Washington.